A reading from the Rule of St. Benedict. There is a good zeal which separates from evil and leads to God and everlasting life. This good zeal, which members must foster with fervent love, they should try to show, be the first to show respect to the other, supporting with greatest patience one another's weakness of body and behavior, and earnestly competing in obedience to one another. Among themselves, they show the pure love of sisters and brothers to God, reverent and humble love. Let them refer nothing whatsoever to Christ, and may Christ bring us all together to eternal life.
Sister Catherine, I would like to present these two women to you as Benedictine associates.
Linda Anderson and Mary Kozmik.
Please come forward.
We thank God for the blessing of these women who have made the discernment for a one-year commitment to serve this monastic community as Benedictine associates. We affirm and bless you, Linda and Mary Lou, for the good zeal that you express. And so I ask you, do you wish to make this commitment as Benedictine associates of this monastic community?
I do. Why are we committed? Well, I look back on my big fat binder of that fat since the get-go in 2011, starting to think about what kind of membership this might be, or our association this might look like. And in 2014, Mary Lou and I were the first oblates, and we're back. And we're back here once again, and again and again, because this is what we each seek. We each seek, I think, and especially for myself, that stability. You're here. You're my community of not only faith, but sisterhood, and community, and hospitality, all those values that I witness every time I'm here and I'm with you, so that I can not only share that with you and support each other, but I can take it back to the community I now live in with other seniors and try to foster that Benedictine influence in a Lutheran environment. So that's, I think, in the important pieces for me. And I guess the beauty of it is it has changed as you have changed, as we have changed. And with our commitments, I want to end with a prayer. This is for all of us as we look ahead to the next year. Let us resolve to do our best, however small our contribution may be, to pray this world forward, to find support for those in need, to gather God's people around a plan of peace, and to make our lives of our elders an honored place among us. To show our children by action what community can be when we build without walls.
Let us make this vision in our work a calling each of us can embrace, a shared goal that unites us across borders and lifts our hearts and hopes. Let us resolve to do what we were made to do, and do it with abundant joy for God's glory.
If I may be so bold as to share a piece of my story that happened recently that I felt centers on good zeal, I would say that this year, or in particular this last month, the commitment to good zeal has really shone forth for me. Because very recently, I had the opportunity, or I was blessed with the opportunity, to continue what I know as my personal pilgrimage or personal journey. I went with a friend, Julie, to Greece and Turkey. And there we met local guides who introduced us to local artisans. And in Greece, it was perhaps the easiest to show respect for another person, because at least three times with three different local guides, we were told, the people of Greece are 95% practicing Greek Orthodox Christians, and their hospitality was outstanding. And similarly in Turkey, where we received a very heartwarming welcome. I'm experiencing a little jet lag, so I have to refer to some notes. In Turkey, we were told that the Islamic culture, at least in Istanbul, which is the largest 20 million people city, has become a lot more secular. But even still, their hospitality was outstanding. And for my part, I wish to remember that all people belong to one body in Christ, and whether that's expressed uniquely or unconditionally, it's just something I want to live by and be able to show respect for whatever other person. And when I return home to St. Paul, it's this community of Benedictine sisters that I feel is a bedrock of Christian values and a bedrock of transmitting those values to anyone who visits here, like good zeal, humility, hospitality, love of God, love of nature, all of it. So I wish to express my gratitude, and I deeply appreciate the community, and wish to thank you all for your continued loving support.
So I invite you, Linda and Mary, to stand here before the altar as we offer a blessing over you. I ask the members of the monastic community to please rise, and we will do our blessing once.
Jesus, compassion of God, grant us your wisdom, we pray.
Guide your people with love.
Eternal Spirit of God, give rest to those who labor and are burdened, we pray.
Guide your people with love.
Let us offer together our praise to God as we pray the words that Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Lord our God, you filled the blessed Abbot Benedict with a spirit of your Son, and made him a master in the way of perfection. As we celebrate his entrance into glory, may we attain that love which surpasses all understanding. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Prayer for the election of priors.
Spirit of the living God, come upon our community with the fullness of your wisdom, your sharing, and your light. Open our minds and hearts so that we may know the power of your presence as we listen to your voice in our hearts, in your word, and in our sisters. Break down any barriers that may separate us. Give us the courage to move into the future with hope as we co-create the vision to which you are calling us. Spirit of the living God, breathe upon us your wisdom, truth, and joy. Amen.
May the peace of Christ be with us and grant us a restful night.
Amen.